Academy Museum of Motion Pictures. Spanning 16 miles from downtown LA to the Pacific, Wilshire Boulevard played a key role in the development of Los Angeles, representing virtually every major architectural style of the 20th century, including what is perhaps the most resplendent example of Streamline Moderne in LA, the May Company Wilshire Building. This gleaming tower at the intersection of Wilshire and Fairfax with its striking black and gold corner has been stopping traffic literally since 1939. In the early 1990s, a May Company merger forced multiple store locations to close, including May Company Wilshire. Soon after, plans were announced to sell the property to a developer who planned to demolish the building entirely. The Los Angeles Conservancy jumped into action, and along with the help of the community and late council member John Ferraro, May Company Wilshire was given landmark status in 1992. Even though it was sold to the LA County Museum of Art in 1994, it failed to flourish and sat vacant and underused for years. Thankfully, the Academy of Motion Pictures Arts and Sciences saw its red carpet potential and leased it as the site of its future Academy Museum.
I think it was in 2016, I came to Los Angeles with a painting that was going to be on loan from the Guggenheim to LACMA. And my good pal, Fred Goldstein, is general counsel at the time at LACMA, and we did a walk around the campus, and he pointed over to a very large, hulking building that, in my view, looked like they had seen better days. He said, that's gonna be the site of the Academy Museum of Motion Pictures.
The Academy Museum project set out on an ambitious adaptive reuse project for the existing historic building, as well as a bold new addition to the north side. Nearly all of the existing historic materials and features were retained and preserved.
The building has a limestone facade, and I learned that the original limestone that was used in construction in the 30s was from a quarry in Texas. And while that quarry was still not operating, the great team who had been working on the building found the closest quarry to find the limestone to use to restore the facade, which I thought was amazing. And then the gold cylinder, which is the iconic, you know, piece of the building, part of the building that people just identify with it, was made of gold tile from Venice, and that the team found the same factory in Venice where the gold tile had been manufactured in the 30s and transported to Los Angeles, and they had gone to that amazing research.
Many auto-age buildings have large parking lots which enable new construction to house new uses and expansion. In this case, a 140-foot diameter spherical addition of glass and steel was added to the north. Often referred to as the Death Star, the sphere was designed to house the museum's theater and viewing deck.
Yeah, I actually like to call it the Life Star because I think that's more in keeping with the spirit of our museum. It was such a complicated project, meaning it was the restoration of a wonderful old building, the construction of this new building, making those two structures work in harmony with each other, the building systems, projection booths in our theaters, complicated components that really at the end of the project have to work in harmony together.
Since its opening, the museum has made an immediate contribution to Los Angeles, helping to solidify Museum Row on the Miracle Mile as a major cultural institution and visitor destination.
We're not just attracting visitors from around the world, which is wonderful, but it's a real center for people in Los Angeles that they want to come back.
Hollywood is always reinventing itself, so it only seems appropriate for a building to reinvent itself to showcase the spectacular history of the movies.